Hey, Tiny Town friends, it is so great to see you for Tiny Town Worship today. Thank you for coming to hang out with me. We have a really awesome story today about a man named Jonah. Jonah was a prophet, which means he gave people very important messages from God. Well, God had a very important message for Jonah to take to a city, which Jonah didn't really want to go to. God told Jonah to go to Nineveh and tell the people there to go God's way. Jonah had a better idea and decided to do things his way instead of God's way. Something very interesting happened to Jonah. Let's check out our story to hear all about Jonah's fascinating adventure.
Hello there, friends. I'm Farmer Fred. And I'm here to tell you another true story from the Bible. Today's true story is about a guy named Jonah. One day, God told Jonah to go to Nineveh. If Nineveh is that way, what do you think Jonah did? Did he go God's way? Nope. Everyone say, "Oh, Jonah, not that way." God told Jonah to go to Nineveh and tell the people there to go God's way. But Jonah didn't want to go to Nineveh. Jonah thought that he had a better idea. He wanted to sail on a boat far, far away from Nineveh. That's right. Jonah didn't go God's way. Instead, he got in a boat to sail away in the opposite direction of Nineveh. Jonah wanted to do things his way instead of God's way. While Jonah was in the boat, big storm came up. Wind rocked the boat, and the rain got everything soaking wet. Jonah knew that God sent the storm for him, so in order to save the other people on the boat, he threw himself into the water. Immediately, the storm stopped, and then God sent a giant fish to swallow Jonah. So there Jonah was, inside the belly of the big fish. Now, do you think Jonah should have gone God's way? Sometimes we think we have a better way, but God's way is perfect, and we can all trust him. Jonah prayed and told God he was very sorry that he didn't go God's way. Then he praised God and knew that God's way is perfect. When Jonah finished praying, God made the giant fish spit Jonah out onto dry land. Now, do you think Jonah decided to go God's way after all of that? Yes. So Jonah went, and guess what happened? The people there decided to go God's way, because God's way is perfect. Wasn't that a wonderful story? It's one of my favorites. Okay, friends, it's time to pray. Let's close our eyes and talk to God together. Dear God, thank you for the story of Jonah. Thank you for showing him the right way and that he finally went to Nineveh. We want to go your way because your way is perfect. Help us follow you always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thanks for listening, everybody. See you next time. Bye.
You are perfect every single day.
crazy story. Jonah didn't go God's way. Instead, he got into a boat and sailed away in the opposite direction of Nineveh, in the opposite direction of where God wanted him to go. Jonah wanted to do things his way instead of God's way. Jonah knew God sent that big storm for him. So in order to save the others, he threw himself out of the boat into the water. The storm stopped, and God sent a giant fish to swallow Jonah. When Jonah was inside the big fish, he finally decided to go God's way. We can go God's way too, because we know God's way is perfect, right? Let's say that together. God's way is perfect. 2 Samuel 22:31. That's right. What a great story to remind us how important it is to go God's way. Thank you so much for spending time with me today. Remember, God's way is perfect. See you next time.